I'm Santosh Gadankar. Today I'm teaching you dynamics of machine. In the dynamics of machine, I'm focusing towards the Artnull governor. I'm doing the force analysis. This is the Artnull governor consisting of a spring at the center of the shaft. And this is the sleeve. These are the balls connected to the bell crank lever. This is a bell crank lever. When the load increases, this is going to move outside, which in turn the fuel will enter into the chamber. And when the load is decreases, it moves towards the center, which in turn decreases the flow of supply of the fuel. Okay, this is the basic idea of the Artnull governor. Now I am taking the one side of the Artnull governor, that is half part I am taking from the axis of the governor axis, where this is nothing but what? A. And this is I am considering a B, where W plus S divided by 2. W is nothing but the sleeve weight, plus S is nothing but the spring. The spring which act here, plus S divided by 2, because I am taking the half portion here. This is the mean value, this is the mean, this is the maximum, this is the maximum, and this is the minimum. This is the minimum. Let R2 be the maximum radius. This is the R2 is the maximum radius, and R1 is the minimum radius, or mean radius. R1 is the minimum radius. Next, this is the centrifugal force which is acting outside. These are centrifugal force. This is for the mean, this is for the maximum, and this is for the minimum. And next is about the spring. This is S1 is for the maximum spring, or this is for the average, and this is for the minimum. And where X is nothing but what? Total lift. We call it as a lift here. Total lift. Where A is nothing but the length of the vertical or bell arm. And this is we referred as a B is nothing but the length of the horizontal or sleeve arm, referred as a sleeve. Always A is greater than B here. Always A should be greater than B. X is nothing but total lift. M is nothing but mass of the balls. And W is nothing but central weight or weight of the sleeve. It can be written in terms of mass, that is mg divided by 2, you can write it. Mg divided by 2. Where the mean, where N2 is nothing but maximum equilibrium speed of R2, mean equilibrium speed of R, and minimum equilibrium speed of R1. I'm going to derive this one. First, I will take the moment about the O. I'm considering the moment about the O here. Moment about the O. Taking moment about O for maximum radius, neglecting the mass of ball and obliquity of mass, arms. That means I am taking the moment about O, then it can be written for the maximum. It can be written as what? F2 into A. Everything this is A. F2 into A is equal to, for this one, F2 is equal to A is equal to, for this part, we have to write W plus S2 divided by 2 into this value, B you have to write. This is equation 1. Equation 1, or you can write it as W plus S2 is equal to 2 A divided by B F2. You can write it. You can consider the equation 1 or let it be. Next, I will take the moment about O for the minimum radius. We have taken for the maximum, now I am considering for the minimum radius. For this part, I am considering. Taking moment about O for the minimum radius, neglecting the mass of the ball ball and obliquity of arms. Then it can be written as what? This one, it can be written as F2 into A, A is equal to, for this one, this you have to write W plus S1 divided by 2 into B. Now it can be written as what? W plus S1 is equal to 2 into A by B F2. F2. So this is equation 1. This is equation 2. Equation 2. Now subtract equation 1 minus 2 gives, you can write S2 minus S1, WW get cancelled, is equal to 2 A by B common. It can be written as F2 minus F1. Also, spring force is equal to S2 minus S1 is nothing but KX. What is K? K is nothing but the stiffness of the spring. Stiffness of the spring. X is nothing but the lift from the maximum to minimum. Maximum to minimum from the figure. It is from figure. From the figure. Now, consider triangle. Now we have to consider the triangle OB1, B2. And you can consider this one as A, A2 and A1. If you consider the triangles, if we just assume it, it is in this form. This is A2, this is A1, and this will be in this form. O, O, B2, B1. Now similar triangle. What is the here? Distance is nothing but x. Here it is nothing but what? R2 minus R1. R2 minus R1. R1. R2 minus R1. Now this can be written as what? In this way you can write it. Similar triangle. Similar triangle. Consider the triangle. Triangle I am considering. O, B1, B2. And triangle O, A1, A2 are similar. Are similar. Then what happened? First, I will consider this one. X divided by R2 minus R1. It's a similar triangle. Is equal to. This is nothing but what? B. This is A. It can be written as B by A. This is also A. This is also B. It can be written B by A. Final formula will be x is equal to b by a r2 minus r1. R2 minus r1 when it is maximum to minimum. Next, now I will substitute in this equation. In this equation, it becomes s2 minus s1 is equal to B divided by A, B divided by A, K, R2 minus R1. Equating, considering this as A, and this one as a B. Equating A and B, it can be written as S B by A R2 minus R1 is equal to 2 A by B F2 minus F1. Then the rate of spring cross multiply, you can obtain rate of spring or stiffness of the spring. I have to write K here. in place of this one, I have substituted this one. Okay, I have write K. K here. The place of stiffness of the spring. Stiffness of the spring is nothing but K is equal to 2 A by B whole square F2 minus F1 divided by R2 minus R1. R2 minus R1. Okay. This is the important formula for finding the stiffness of the spring. Next, at any instant, I'm writing the direct formula. This extension is not required. You can write directly here. F is equal to F1 plus F2 minus F1 divided by R minus R1 divided by R2 minus R1. Further calculations are not required. It's unnecessary. You can write directly this part. You have to mug up this one. Where F1 is nothing but M omega 1 square R1. F is nothing but M omega, omega R. F2 is nothing but M omega 2 square R2. Now further, it can be written as, omega can be written as, omega 1 can be written as 2 pi N1 divided by 60. Next omega can be 2 pi n divided by 60. One more omega, omega 2. 2 pi n 2 divided by 60. This is the derivation for the Hartnell. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.